In 1 Corinthians 15, 19, Apostle Paul, looking at the life of believers, as it was then, there's nothing new under heaven. Human beings are still the same. Hallelujah. You see, the devil has not changed. The same devil they contended with in Bible time is the same devil we are contending with now. Forget about Instagram, forget about Facebook, forget about the modernization we have. Satan is not modernized. Is this the same devil we are dealing with? The same old devil that they contested with in the Bible is still the same old devil that we are dealing with. Coming to America has not changed the devil. The facilities you enjoy here has not changed the devil. The devil is still a devil who hates you. Who doesn't want you to make heaven? Who doesn't want you to fulfill the purpose of God for your life? Who wants to deceive you? He's still the same old devil. As you look at the scripture in 1 Corinthians 15, 19, because of the practices of the people, because of how many of them took salvation in vain, and they were thinking it was just all about self, about themselves, and they were just living for vanity, and none of them were strong enough to step into their functioning as a priest, Apostle Paul wrote this. You need to read the letters and read the scriptures. If you're a believer, read the Bible, read the Word of God. I tell Christian, if all you listen to is preacher, you may not end up well. Every preacher has their own emphasis. And when they come, they will preach in the area of their emphasis. But that's not the whole Bible. No one man of God can read the whole Bible. But you have the Bible for you to read as a priest. It's your manual. It's your job description. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. We all have offices we occupy here. We get to know about our offices. We get to know about things in this country, right? So we can enjoy. 1 Corinthians 15, 19. It says, if in this life only, if coming to Christ is about this life only, if redemption is about this life only, if all the reason why you come to church and you are living a life of a believer and you say you are following Christ is only for this life only, listen to what the Bible says. If you are being born again, has no relevance to the kingdom, has no relevance to purpose, has no relevance to what God has called you to do. If you are coming to Christ, has no relevance to what you are going to give account to God one day in eternity. If all you are doing is living for self as a believer, listen to what the Bible says. It says, if in this life only, we have hope in Christ, we are of all men most miserable. I tell people, there is nothing you will get in Christ by reason of material blessing that the devil cannot counterfeit. Nothing. Satan also gives some people breakthrough. You don't believe me? He does. That's why witch doctors are selling in Africa. There are juju you can make and you will get breakthrough. There are things you can do in your store and customers will be coming. And they will pass 37 stores and they will only come to your store. Just hang it in there. My wife and I used to go to one eatery in Nigeria, in Ibadan. They sell pounded yam, not the one you turn around here. Where they say, Pastor, eat pounded yam. I say, yeah, is it really pounded yam? Where was it pounded? I said, this is the rubber you are eating here. This is not pounded yam. The one you can microwave after 1 week. It's not pounded yam. Pounded yam, when you make it in the morning, by evening, it's turned bad already. So we used to go somewhere to read original pounded yam and ogufe in Nigeria. You know what it's called, ogufe? Goat meat. with vegetable and with Ebola. That is, what is the way to, how do I translate that? Green. Okay, let me do the translation. Thank you. We used to go there, we'd take the children when they were young, and we used to go there. The woman cooked very well. And then one day, as I was eating, my eyes just, I don't know, I've entered that place countless times. That day, I just lifted up my eyes, my face, I just lifted up, and I saw one thing by the door entrance. The thing was there like that. Like, hey, whoa. What is this? So I challenged the woman. I said, woman, I said, do you think this is what is bringing me to come here? It's more than 15 years now. I told her, I said, from today, you will not see me here anymore. He said, no, sir. He said, no, sir. It is Jesus we are using to sell here. He said, they just, because they wanted to demolish the building, somebody advised me I should do this thing so that government will not demolish. The thing was demolished eventually. Listen, the devil can counterfeit everything. That's where I'm going. So if your Christianity is only for what the devil can also counterfeit, or you don't know Satan gave people children. Oh yeah, he does. What are spirits? God does not withhold from people. Are you listening to me here? So this thing is not just about us. It's about our assignment. And the reason why God is blessing you, blessing the church, healing you, making way for you, is so that you can be released from the assignment. That's the essence, that's the purpose. And so you must not lose sight of your primary thing. You are called to be a priest. You are not called to prosperity, you are called to be a priest. You need prosperity to function as a priest. You need healing to function as a priest. You need to be whole, you need to be strong. You need to overcome so that you can be free. Luke chapter 1. So that you can be free. So your deliverance is tied to something. Your healing is tied to something. Your prosperity is tied to something. So where your focus should be is in your priesthood, is in your assignment to make sure when you stand before God in eternity, this is what really matters. It doesn't matter what happened here. What happened in eternity? One day, you are going to stand before God in eternity. And you will not give account of your designer wares. You will not give account of how many mansions you built. You will give account of your involvement in the kingdom of God on earth. How many souls did you bring to the kingdom? How many souls did you win? What part did you play all the years in Dunamis Lashabu? To see that the church grows, to see that needs are met, to see that you are part, that you are recognized in heaven. Pastor may not recognize you. You are not serving because of pastor. You are serving because of your assignment to give account to God. You are not serving to be recognized by man. No. Pastor has only two eyes. If he's looking one direction, he cannot look at this direction. Only God has the ability to look to. Bible says his eye run to and fro. You recall him, Olojubieti Ajere. That is, it's like the head of God is full of eyes. If God stands like this, he's looking at the back. Glory be to God. So there's nothing that you do that God will not recognize. Glory be to God. Are you glad this morning? I'm excited I'm not serving man. I'm excited my reward is not from man. I'm excited I'm not serving because of man. I'm not serving for human recognition. I'm excited that the God of heaven look at me and he say, well done, my faithful servant. I'm sure God is looking at somebody here this morning and say, I'm pleased with you. Having loved you, having paid the price, having died for you to make you a priest. Luke chapter 1, verse 67. Amen. Luke chapter 1, verse 67. I pray you will arise. You will not fail heaven. You will not disappoint heaven. You will not disappoint your calling. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. You will not disappoint your calling. Luke chapter 1 verse 67. And his father Zechariah, the father of John the Baptist, was filled with the Holy Ghost and prophesied. So this was a prophecy by the Holy Spirit, saying, blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he has visited and redeemed his people and has raised up an horn of salvation, that is the Lord Jesus, for us in the house of his servant David, as he spoke. So Jesus came to fulfill prophecy. As he spoke by the mouth of his holy prophets, God has been speaking and talking about Christ right from the Garden of Eden. God spoke about Christ, the seed of the woman. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As he spoke by the mouth of his holy prophets, from which he has, which have been since the world began, that we should be saved from our enemies and from the hand of all that hate us, to perform the mercy promised to our fathers, and to remember his holy covenant. Verse 73, the oath which he swore by our father Abraham. How many of you know you are Abraham's child? Hallelujah. In Christ Jesus, we are the seed of Abraham. Hallelujah. By faith in Christ Jesus. The oath which he swore by our father Abraham. Verse 74, that he will grant unto us. Your victory is a done deal. Your deliverance is a done deal. Your healing is a done deal. The Lord Jesus Christ said, healing is the children's bread. We are not to come to church and beg for that. That is your inheritance. Prosperity is your inheritance. Healing is your inheritance. If somebody listen to me, we are not beggars. We can take the gospel to hidden nations and declare the gospel to them and make them well. But for us in the kingdom, these things is our inheritance. Your children don't come home and beg you for food. They don't beg you for their school fees. They don't beg you for the clothes to wear. Your children come, and as a matter of fact, they expect their needs to be met. Even if you have to go borrow, doesn't concern them. Our second child, very wonderful lady, is married with her own baby now. And my first daughter, she's very gentle. Firstborn are always very gentle, like me. A secondborn, a lady. My firstborn will come and say, daddy, can I have 500 naira? I'm blessed now. So daddy, she will understand. She will understand. My second daughter, she will come, daddy, can I have 500 naira? Thank you, sir. She won't wait for reply. She won't wait for reply. It is your headache now to permutate and calculate and do whatever you need to do to produce the 500 naira. She has asked, she has gone. And she's the one that is always getting. The one that is considerate, we always cheat her. Because she's considerate. She said, okay, daddy, you don't have it now. Okay, don't worry, don't worry, don't worry, don't worry. But the one that said, thank you, sir. Come on, tell someone it is your inheritance. Come on, say, healing is your inheritance. Victory is your inheritance. Deliverance is your inheritance. We don't beg for that. We don't beg for that. That is not what we gather around. We don't gather around that in the church. That's not what we gather around. Unfortunately, that has become what we gather around churches today. No, that is our inheritance. We should gather around Christ to be strengthened, to be encouraged, to go back and serve and bring report. Hallelujah. And go serve and bring report. And go serve and bring report. And then gather and pray and take authority against every power of the enemy. Not against your healing. Nothing can stop your healing. But you see, the Bible is talking about the advance of the gospel. He said, I will build my church and the gates of hell. The gates of hell is trying to stop the advance of the gospel. It is you and I that must make sure that the gospel extends and expands. That's what we pray. Our prayer meeting should be for that. It should center around that, not for healing, deliverance. That one is already set to now. It's already set to be in the kingdom. Jesus Christ said, he said, I cannot give the food of the children, I cannot give it to dogs. How many of you know you are in charge in the kingdom of God this morning? Healing is your inheritance, deliverance is your inheritance, prosperity is your inheritance, breakthrough is your inheritance. No power of hell can stop what Jesus has accomplished on the cross of Calvary. There is no devil that can stop it. It is already settled in Christ. Settled in Christ. That he will grant to us that we've been delivered from the hand of our enemies may serve him. May serve him. That's where the issue is. May serve him. Without fear, without fear. No child of God should go around and be afraid. Fearful. I don't even know what they are doing at home now. And they are taking my name. Let them take your name to anywhere. Fire will catch them there. As they mention your name, fire will answer. Holy Ghost fire. I said, Baba, this is the name of that woman that is in America. I don't want her to prosper. I said, what is her name? He said, Adetokunbo. Okay. Adetokunbo. As they call you now, make it just the answer me. It doesn't matter where you are in that America. I said, nothing can stop the wind from blowing. And as the wind is blowing in America now, you answer me, Adetokunbo. You know what we answer? Fire. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire with Joshua. And the Baba will say, which name did you bring? You don't need to be afraid. He said, we will serve without fear. Without fear. Without fear. No fear of death. No fear of sickness. No fear of oppression. Because we are redeemed. Without fear. All the days of our life. How many days? All. It's guaranteed. No insurance can guarantee you that in America. The insurance, you must make sure you pay their premium. Now to give to God is a problem, but you pay insurance every month. Because you want to be highly insured. And then the kingdom that matters to God, you cannot give. To give you check, you calculate. You calculate. After every need is met, then the leftover, you divide again. Some of us will be disappointed in heaven. I hope it shall not be you. Some believers will be terribly disappointed in heaven. Serve him all the days of our lives in holiness and righteousness before him all the days of our life. This is what it's all about. You know what the Bible says in James? Let's look at this book. In James, the book of James, chapter 4. Verse 3. And I think I should begin to round up, right? Right? Okay. James chapter 4, verse 3. James 4, 3. Listen to this scripture. Very strange scripture in the Bible. Very strange. You ordinarily we don't expect to find this kind of scripture in the Bible. But see, like I told you, Satan is the same devil. As he distracted the early church, he's also distracting the church today. Listen, verse 3. Ye ask and receive not. He's talking to believers. You do vigil, you pray. You do everything. You quote scriptures. You blow tongues. You do all the gymnastics. One day God told me, many years ago, when somebody gave me some money, and God said, I will return it. And after a while, I said, God, why should I return this money? He said, tell the man, I'm not a gambling machine. I'm not a gambling machine. Like, you just put something in, and there's something come out. God is spirit. God is spirit. And they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. We can turn Bible to technicalities and just turn it to just procedures of sowing and reaping. and just do it technically and I don't know how to put this name. Without the Spirit, mechanically. So he said, you ask and you don't receive not. You ask and receive not because you ask wrongly. Because you ask wrongly. And when you are asking, you don't know you ask wrongly. But God listens more than your words. God listens more than, God read more than your lips. God read your heart when you are asking. So you receive not because you ask wrongly, that you may consume it upon your lust. Because your heart is not okay. Your heart is not correct. Your heart is competitive. The reason why you want to buy a new car is because you want them to know in that church. That's your reason. The reason why you want to wear a new suit is because you want them to know in that church. And God says all that. I say, you keep asking and you keep receiving not because you